back out to Kristine in Hoboken with a look at where this investigation may be headed next. Kristine.
Yeah, thank you, Maurice. Actually joining me now is a engineering expert, Professor Robert Paswell with City College. Thank you so much for being here with us this afternoon.
Glad to be here.
In your opinion, what could be the causes of this? What are the possibilities?
First of all, the person was going too fast, whatever happened. And you can't forget that. So if there was a signal malfunction, if there was something on the tracks, he was still going fast coming into the station. So the real question comes down to, why was he going at that speed as he approached the station? The train has a tremendous amount of momentum. You're going 30 miles an hour, a couple of 1,000 yards from the station, you should be slowing down. And I think some of the passengers said they felt they were still going fast. So I would look at what was the locomotive engineer thinking. Now, the locomotive was in the back, but they're able to see to the front by either TV cameras or radio, so they know what's going on. And so that could be it. It could be a signal malfunction, perhaps, further down the road. It could be something in the track, but the most likely story is that the person should have been slowing down. I mean, that's sort of obvious, and they weren't. And the question is, why? I mean, and that's something that the National Transportation Safety Board is going to have to find out.
I know you can't be exact, but can you give us a sense of the speed this train was coming in at, just judging by the pictures that you've seen today?
Well, from what I've seen and from what's been reported in the press, they were going 20, 30, 30, 35 miles an hour. And when you're pulling the station, you should be going 10 to 15 miles an hour so you can actually stop. Remember, a train weighs a lot. It's got a tremendous amount of momentum, you know, which is the weight times the speed. So you just can't stop it on a dime. So you need to slow down. And I think we all know when a subway train comes into a station, you feel it often too sharp, but you feel the brakes coming on, and it's two city blocks that they're stopping in. And
NTSB just arrived here on the scene. Take us into their investigation. What are their priorities when they get here?
Well, their priority is obviously to find out what happened. And so they look at every aspect. They look at the right-of-way. Was there something on the right-of-way? They look at the signals in the signal system. They look if there's something in the station. And they want to interview anybody who's concerned, especially the motorman. What was the motorman doing at the time? I don't know if it was a man or a woman. What was the motorman doing at the time? And what was their thought process? And then they also look. Trains have black boxes like airplanes. They look at the conditions on the train to see what was happening and see how it goes together with what the motorman thought was happening.
Positive train control.
Right.
It's a technology that will stop a train if it's going over a certain speed. But yet we've had an issue here in our country to get these installed. In your opinion, do you feel as though that this is a necessity?
Absolutely. I think everyone feels it's a necessity. The railroads, the freight railroads especially, they originally came out for the freight railroads and the commuter rail, like New Jersey Transit is. And the reason is that if a train is going too fast, you want to take the train out of whoever's driving it too fast hands and stop it. And I think one of the real ironies is now you can buy a car now that if it gets too close to another car, it will break itself. And if they can have it quickly on cars, why don't they have it on trains?
Will it be a lifesaver?
It would absolutely be a lifesaver.
Professor Paswell, thank you so much for your expertise. It was a pleasure meeting you.
You too.
All right.
Thank you.
And do stay with CBS2 here as we continue our team coverage of the deadly train crash here in Hoboken.